obviously people around the world see these pictures of kids and want to adopt them. Is the adoption the best answer right now?
No. I think adoption is great for those families who are already in the queue. They got the papers all lined up, and they meet the requirements that have been created by the State Department on January 18th. But I think there's a bigger picture here, and since I've been here the last 3 days, I've seen that the teams need to be put together, NGOs, government organizations, to make their best effort to organize the way in which we manage children so they can be protected.
Because at this point, frankly, we don't even know how many, we don't know the scope of the problem.
No clue. Could be tens
of thousands, hundreds of thousands.
Right.
More.
It could turn out to be small numbers. It could turn out to be that many families in the communities have absorbed the children. They're in the refugee camps. The most important thing we need to do is make sure that the children are protected and safe, and that they're obviously fed, and they get food and water and clothes. And then the second step, which we're moving into gradually in the next few months, is their mental health.
And that's a real concern, obviously.
Very concerned. I mean, the main thing that you see, we were in an orphanage today early, and we see that the kids are, really very loved by the nannies, very cared for, and yet you see that there's a real fear and anxiety and withdrawal that they experience because they are frightened. They're without their families, and then on top of this, they've experienced a terrible disaster, which they don't understand.
And you have these aftershocks, so it continues. I mean, there's justifiable
reasons. In fact, the kids don't want to be inside anymore.
Right.
When we were at the orphanage today, they all want to camp outside in their tents. They're now interested in this sort of outside life. Even the church is doing masses outside.
For a lot of folks who want to adopt internationally right now, I mean, they could also help with stabilizing kids here.
Absolutely.
I mean, kids here can have a productive life if they're raised in the right way.
Thank you for saying that. I mean, that's the work. The other part of my work is, where I work in other countries, Worldwide Orphans Foundation has programs in many countries all around the world to help orphans reach their potential, good medical care, education, sports, arts, whatever it is. Kids can have a fantastic life in their own countries if there are proper services. But I think I want to go back to the fact that if people want to do something good for kids here in Haiti, I think there are many organizations they can contribute to. Many.
What would you recommend?
Well, I recommend a whole smorgasbord. Partners in Health and Save the Children, UNICEF, International Medical Corps, Red Cross, the list, it's endless.
You didn't say your own group. Don't you need funds?
We're not in Haiti.
Okay.
And so we're not raising funds. What I came here to do, and I'm really excited to say that, is I came here to be a credible character. I came to find out what was going on here, to be able to go home, speak to people in the United States about what is going on so people get educated and so no one's confused about adoption.
So bottom line, you say kids who are in the pipeline now should go for international adoptions. That should be allowed to proceed. But for the kids who are now, it's too confusing a situation and a lot can be done for them here now.
Absolutely.
Immediately.
And let me tell you, I went to the UN compound yesterday. I met with the UNICEF folks and all kinds of other NGOs. They are incredibly organized. It's impressive. And we just hope that people will continue with the momentum of being committed to that hard work. Because that work is years.
It's only just begun.